Yeah, I gotta tell you, the more we learn about these guns, this is a sniper rifle. Not really, but it looks like one though, right? The more we learn how dangerous they can be. We've got Kevin Shimwell here with us with Carolina Outdoor Adventure. Kevin, thanks for being here with us today. Mm-hmm. One problem, just transporting these things in your car.
That's correct, Trey. You know, when you are transporting any type of, guns or weapons, you know, you want to make sure they're secured in the trunk, make sure it's got an orange tip on the gun that comes with it when you purchase one that they are. And safety of transporting is extremely vital. You know, police officers, they don't know what they're looking at. They look through the, you know, when they see a gun, whether it's a real gun or it's not. So, you know, that orange tip and transporting correctly is very important.
All right. Now we're going to talk about the troublemakers, the guys that are causing trouble with these guns. I'm going to refer to Alan Covey with the North Carolina Airsoft Organization. Alan, who are the troublemakers in these situations?
Well, the people that we're finding out that are getting in trouble with airsoft guns are the people who are going to get in trouble with anything that you might give them that's legal to have, but they're misusing it. They're guys that are taking them out in public. They're teenagers that are buying really cheap guns and spray painting, say, a clear plastic gun, or they're actually modifying a gun. Now, this is actually an airsoft gun with some additions, some shotgun shells that are actually empty and some other things. But if a police officer sees this as it's getting dark like it is right now, right, it can be a real danger for them and anybody who might be holding it. So we really try to get people to play in controlled environments. Don't play in your backyard. Don't take these out in public. The police officers really don't have a second to kind of decide what they're going to do. They need to react.
Absolutely. We've got a lot of more useful information coming up for you here later on. Of course, don't miss our special report, Toying with Danger. That's going to air at 6 o'clock. Guys, back to you.
A Vietnam battle coming up on the 14th. There will be a night mission on Friday night, so get here early on Friday. Registration ends at 8 o'clock that night, and we'll have a pregame night game. As I said, Friday night, starting about 10 o'clock, our mission. Then, of course, Saturday all day, be here bright and early. Game on at 10. There'll be a safety briefing at 9. It's going to be awesome. Expecting about 100 players.
Yeah, tell me a little bit about the growth of airsoft here, especially in your area. You've kind of picked it up the last couple of years in southeastern North Carolina, along the Grand Strand here in South Carolina. Airsoft really getting to be a strong thing here in the Carolinas, isn't it?
Absolutely. Matter of fact, we've seen our business quadruple over the last year and a half, actually. I can remember our first airsoft game, we had about 12 players. Last game we had 3 months ago, middle of summer, brought in a little over 100, almost 150 players. So we were very pleased with the growth.
What is it about airsoft that you think guys in this area are interested in the most, and gals, too, because you've got some female players?
Well, airsoft is very, I mean, interested. The player's interest in airsoft is only the sport itself, but I think what we have to here offer it at the park is the urban city. We've got the woods. We've got everything set up for an absolutely incredible airsoft game.
And folks that come down here really get a great experience. It's not just slinging BBs back and forth, because you've got a lot of props and a lot of scenario ideas you try to work into the games, and virtually everything has a theme, too.
That is correct. Matter of fact, the most fun part about the game is when we have one of our props, we put out a down pilot situation where we've got two reconnaissance teams going out to locate it. Then we have an extraction team that will go in and extract the dummy. And watching these guys carry this 100, 150-pound dummy through the woods and trying to get them back to a location is really quite something.
And the action can get pretty intense, too.
Absolutely.
Because it's pretty close back in there and close
mm-hmm.
to rain. All in all, what do you want to do in terms of expanding the park in the future?
Well, we do have some expansion plans. I'd like to leave those as a surprise for later, but we're continuing to grow all the time. Our new expansion that we just finished doing was putting a piece in between the woods and the town, urban town. We now have what we call our farm area, which has a tobacco barn and some things that represent a farm or a farm community.
So even if you've been here before, you're going to find new things this time in a game coming up a couple of Saturdays from now.